In this unit, we'll learn about two types of HTTP protocols, called persistent and non-persistent protocols. As we've learned in previous units, a web page consists of objects, sometimes even a large amount of them. Likewise, HTTP uses a TCP protocol, which is connection-oriented, that is, establishes a connection at the beginning and closes it at the end. A non-persistent protocol is a protocol which opens a TCP connection for each object separately and closes it after receiving the object. Which means that if the client wants to receive several objects from the server, it will need to open several connections. That is, one connection for each of the objects it wants to get. Afterward, it will close the connection separately. A persistent protocol is a protocol which is open and remains open along the way, downloads a number of objects, and closes communication when it ends. This method leaves the connection open over time, even if there is a time gap between sending the objects by the server. What are the stages in non-persistent HTTP communication? To demonstrate that, let's say that a client wants to go to someschool.edu. And get a page containing 10 pictures. In the first stage, the client types the URL in their browser, which establishes TCP-based communication on port 80 vis-a-vis the server containing the site. The server, listening to port 80, approves the TCP connection and updates the client with the approval. In the second stage, the client sends an HTTP request, which is an object request from that server. The request is sent via TCP protocol and contains the URL of the desired object. Later on, we'll learn about this request structure. The server receives the requests, locates the required object, packages it in a response query called HTTP response, and sends it to the client. The client gets the response, and the browser presents the object. In the next stage, the server closes the TCP connection and informs the client on closing so that the client can then close the TCP connection on their end as well. The process repeats itself 10 times, once for every image. What is the reaction time in a non-persistent HTTP protocol? First, we'll define what round-trip time, or RTT, is. RTT is the time it takes a small packet, say a single bit, to get from one end of the host to another and back. Usually the concept is understood as a small packet going client to server, and then a small packet from server to client and back. The packet is small to assume short transmission times on both ends. So, what is the reaction time in a non-persistent protocol? The reaction time is the time it takes from the moment the client wants an object from the server until it receives it in its entirety. The reaction time equals 1 RTT for a TCP-based connection, which is the part of establishing the connection, add to that another RTT for the object request by the client to the server and getting it back. And to these, we'll add the transmission time of the object server side. Note that transmission time for the request and the transmission times while establishing connection are relatively negligible because we're talking about very small packets. On the other hand, transmission of the object by the server may take up significant amounts of time as it depends on the size of the object, which can be an image, sound, or even a video. In total, for the entire process, the reaction time is 2 times RTT, plus the object transmission time. As we've studied in the previous unit, the transmission time of an object is defined as its size divided by the bandwidth. And of course, the whole process repeats over and over for each object the client requests from the server. This is the reaction time in non-persistent HTTP protocol. The reaction time in persistent HTTP protocol equals sending a request for the object from the client side and it being received by the server. Because the connection is already established, if this is the second object requested by the client. So the time is defined as RTT plus the object transmission. In the non-persistent method, several connections are usually opened in parallel to get objects faster. Whereas in the persistent method, the server will keep the connection open until the client disconnects from the server. When the connection is open, the client can request a number of objects even with gaps in request times, because the connection is maintained. In this unit, we learned about two types of HTTP: HTTP persistent and HTTP non-persistent, and noted the differences between the methods and the differences in reaction times.